In the previous videos, we saw how to enter data in arrays using an assignment statement, using the BlueJ system and also input stream reader class. Today we are going to see how to use the scanner class. As you are already aware that scanner class is part of the Java's utility package. So we have to import this package, import java.util.star. After that, we can create a scanner object, scanner A. A is a variable. It is an object of the scanner class. Scanner A is equal to new scanner in bracket system.in. This is how we create a scanner object. After creating a scanner object, we will create an integer array. Int n square brackets is equal to new int in square bracket 10. Notice one thing, that int is in small letters here. If you by mistake write a capital I, then it will give you an error at the time of compilation. So int n square bracket is equal to new int in square bracket 10. This will declare an integer array name with elements, 10 elements. After that, we can store data in this integer array using a for loop. We'll use an integer variable I from 0 to less than 10, that will be 10 numbers. N in square bracket I equals to scanner object dot next int. This is the method that will collect the data sent from the keyboard and store it in the integer variable. Now let us run a program to see the use of a scanner class. So our example program for this video is called scanner example. I will post it under this video as a comment. You can copy it from there. Import java.util.star, public class scanner example, public static void main string arguments, int I sum equals to 0. Scanner s is equal to new scanner system.in. Here we declare a scanner object named s. Int n is equal to new int 5. Here we declare an integer array named n having a maximum of 5 elements. Now we can use this integer array n square bracket I inside a for loop, and we will iterate the loop for 5 times from 0 till 4, or I is equal to 0, I is less than 5, that is up until I becomes 4. And each time we will display a message to the user, system.out.print enter any number. And as soon as the user enters a number, we can collect it using this method, s.nextint. S is our scanner object and nextint is the method from the scanner class. So scanner object.nextint, this is the method that we can use from the scanner class to collect the numbers entered from the keyboard and store it in a cell of a integer array. It will store one number at a time. It will accept one number at a time and store it in one array element. So this array element will be n0 till n4. It will collect 5 numbers. When all the 5 numbers are stored, we can create a sum of the array elements. For that, again, we will iterate the loop. For I is equal to 0, I is less than 5, I double plus. Sum is equal to sum plus n in square bracket I. So here we will bring forth all the elements of the array one by one and go on adding it into the sum. So in this case, in this statement, sum is equal to sum plus n0. And whatever the value there is in n0, that will be added into the variable sum. And next time, n1, whatever value there is in n1, that will be added into the sum again. So this way we will get the total number of values, all the values that we can display in the print statement. Here I have added curly brackets after the for loop, but as there is only one statement we are going to use, you can work without these curly brackets. If there is only one statement, we don't need to add curly brackets separately, and we can print the output. We can print the sum using the print statement. Let us save the class, compile it and run it. Now we are going to add any 5 numbers and we will get the sum of the elements of array. You can test this program using different values.